Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn, and in this tutorial we will be looking at advanced AutoPatch. And the reason we would need this is so we can use the Z value and send parts of the body behind other parts of the body. I've got a character here that I've rigged, and if I select the arm, the upper arm, and pose the arm so that it is in front of the body, if I select that piece, which is the forearm, go to Windows, Chord and Control Points, look for the Z value, put in a minus value, so a minus 0.001, we can see it pops behind the body. But what's great here is you can see that it hasn't broken the rig and it's not revealing the line art. This is a great way to put pieces behind or in front of other parts of the body. Let's just reset that and let's start from the beginning. For this tutorial, you'll need a character design and a character breakdown. The main thing is to have the arm broken down into a minimum of three pieces, so an upper arm, a forearm, and a hand. You'll also need to make sure that you put line art in the line art layer and color art in the color art layer. So if we take a look at the hand, we can go to the drawing panel and we can see the line art for the hand is in the line art layer and the color art is in the color art layer. So once you have your assets, so the three pieces for the front arm, let's go ahead and put in the pegs. So let's click and drag to select all the drawing nodes and put in multiple pegs. So that's Shift Command P. Now let's put in a rotation point. So we've put in the rotation point for the arm and we can test that and make sure that's working and then reset. And then let's go to the hand. Let's put in the rotation point for the hand. Let's test that is working and it's not jutting out here. And the most important is the rotation point for the forearm. So I'm going to place it so that when we pose the arm, the elbow doesn't jut out. So it may need a little bit of adjustment. Okay, so now we have the rotation points in, we can do the simple hierarchy, which is just to connect the upper arm or the front arm to the front forearm and the front forearm to the hand. So it's a simple hierarchy here. You can test that's working as well, that they're selected at the top of the hierarchy. I want to just show you why you would need an advanced AutoPatch. What would happen if you just use the AutoPatch node? So I'm going to get my AutoPatch node by hitting enter and putting a U, just the first two letters, and then getting hold of the AutoPatch. So the AutoPatch is connected under the drawing node. And the connector is placed in front of the piece that you want to auto patch. So in this case, it would be the forearm. And we can see it has worked. It's cut the line art. Because the auto patch doesn't have a value, we can just copy and paste that for the hand. So similar way of putting the connector in front or on top of the order for the nodes. So once we've done that, let's test our rig. So again, let's pose our arm in front of the body. Let's select the forearm, go to Windows, go to Coordinate and Control Points, choose the Z value, and then put in a minus value. And when we do that, we can see that the arm has popped behind the body, but the rig is broken because the line art is now revealed because the forearm has been sent back. It breaks the auto patch because the upper arm is still in the same Z value. Therefore, we need an advanced auto patch. Let's just return all this. I'm going to keep the auto patches for now connected and then bring in the other nodes that we would need for the advanced auto patch. And now let's get a line art. And we want to place the line art so it's in position for it to be connected. So the line art I would place over here to the left. And we'll also need a color art. We'll also need a comp. Let's go ahead and get that. With the comp, it is important right now to have the comp set at pass through, and you'll see why a little bit later. First of all, let's connect the line art and the color art, also from underneath the drawing of the upper arm. Let's connect the line art and also the color art. And now we want to connect the composite to the main composite from the front arm and disconnect the original connector. We'll now need to have a cutter for the line art. So let's select the line art and again get our node library and just find the cutter. And here is the cutter. So this is the system or the selection of nodes and the arrangement that you'll need for an advanced auto patch. We can obviously repeat this, but we can also just select the nodes here, excluding the auto patch. So just the nodes for the line art, color art, the cutter and the composite, and copy and paste so that we can repeat the system over here on the forearm. And again, let's connect those and connect to the main composite and disconnect the original connector. Now we're ready to connect the auto patch. So the auto patch for the forearm will cut the line art for the upper arm, and then the auto patch that's connected to the upper arm, the connector will cut the line art for the forearm. And when we do that, we can see it has cut the line art. We now want to repeat this arrangement again, but let's take a look at a way to reduce the length of the nodes. So we can simply rename certain nodes. So for line art, for instance, we can rename it to LA. And for color art, we can abbreviate that as well to CA. And that's just so that your node view doesn't get really cluttered. So it's just a way of saving space and to make the node view nice and tidy. The other way as well is to group, which is just, again, selecting the nodes, and I would leave out the auto patch for the group selection. And let's group, Command G. And now let's select that and copy and paste. And now we can attach that. And also when we click into that system, we can see the arrangement is there and we can just select out to go to the main node view. So we can rename this, so we could call it the system, abbreviate that as well, just so it's nice and short. And now if you hold down your option key, you can snap that in to connect the connectors. With the hand, we'll share this auto patch that is with the forearm and take a connector from the auto patch, connect that or cut the line art for the hand again so that it now has this seamless quality. So now let's test our rig. Let's select the top of the hierarchy, which is the upper arm or what I've named as the front arm. Shift B to go down one, which is the forearm. Pose it so that it's in front of the body. And now with this forearm peg selected, let's again go to Windows, Coordinates and Control Points, find our Z value and put in a minus 0.01. There we can see it's worked. The forearm has popped behind the body using the Z value. It's also retained the rig, so there's no line art revealed when this happens. So this is what we want. And that is the advanced auto patch. Now that we have the arm rigged, we can look at the sleeve. So if we pose the arm again, and we pose the arm in front of the body, when the arm or the forearm pops behind, we may want the sleeve to be adjusted as such, so it can move a little bit up perhaps as the arm pops behind the body. So we're going to look at invert cutting the sleeve, but we're also going to look at the line reveal system as well. So here you can see that the line for the flesh tone stays within the area for the arm, and the line for the sleeve stays within the area of the sleeve. So let's take a look at how we do this. What you'll need is a design for the sleeve, and you can keep that simple. If we go to the drawing, look at the line art, you can make a sleeve by just drawing one line for the bottom of the sleeve in the colour of the actual item of clothing, then fill it in the colour art. So if we have a look at how it would look on the rig, it would look unsightly right now because we haven't rigged it, but we're going to invert cut and create the line reveal system. First of all, let's place the drawing for the sleeve. And for this, just to show you the arrangement of the nodes, the sleeve will need to go above the collar art for the upper arm. So in the composite order, the sleeve is above the collar art node for the front arm only. Let's put in a peg, so Command P, and let's put in the rotation point for this. So for the rotation point, it's sometimes helpful to have the same rotation point as another similar piece for the breakdown. So in this case, I would want the rotation point at the same place as the upper arm or the front arm. So all I would need to do is to open up the properties for the node for the front arm, and then open up the properties for the sleeve and copy and paste those values over here, so on the X and also on the Y. So now those rotation points are identical for the front upper arm and the sleeve. And now we can connect the pegs. So connect the sleeve to the front arm. So now that's done, let's add a cutter to the sleeve. So we want to invert cut the sleeve to the front upper arm. So let's find the cutter over here. What we'll want to do now is take a connector from the front upper arm, connect it to the cutter for the sleeve. Now something's happened here, it's not quite right because it needs to be inverted. You can invert it in two ways. You can open up the properties and check inverted and it will do the job for you. Or the way I like to do it is just to double click on this little mask icon. And now that's invert cut, we're almost there and we can test that's working. So that stays within the area of the arm. And because we've made a bigger piece for the sleeve, it can move around as well. You can also add a deformer, which gives you more of a range, more options as well. Let's just reset that. What we can also see, the color of the line around the sleeve is the same as the flesh tone, which is not what we want. We want the line art color for the t-shirt. So let's go ahead and rig that now. What we would need to do first of all is to select the front upper arm, and let's go to the drawing, and then let's go to select this piece and copy it, and then select the overlay art layer and paste that in. Whilst that's selected, let's find the color that we've used for the t-shirt line art. I have it here and I'm going to select that. And so in my design, it's blue. And now let's just check. So we've got an identical copy of the line art in the overlay art layer and the line art layer as well. The line art has the flesh color and the overlay the t-shirt color. So let's go back to our camera view. Let's see how we can bring that together. So let's go ahead and get an overlay layer by bringing up the node library. So here is the overlay layer and we're going to connect that to the front upper arm. We want the overlay layer to share this rig that the line art already has. But if we try to share this port, it doesn't let us. So what we need is a composite to share this port. So let's bring in a composite. Let's connect the overlay and the line art and then connect both to the cutter. We need to add a cutter to the overlay layer. So let's go to get a cutter. And now what we want to do is to cut this overlay layer, which is connected to the front arm, by the sleeve. So we're going to take this connector and cut it. And we can see it's almost worked, but again, similar thing, we need to invert it. So let's double click, and here we go. And that is invert cutting the sleeve and the line art reveal system. And when we test it, you can see it's going to work. So once you've got the arm rigged, you can test it out by doing a little animation. Let's start with the first keyframe, and just something to remember as well is that you always animate on the top peg. So make sure that your layers are collapsed, which you can do by hitting O. And if you want to reveal the layers, it's 9. So we're going to close all our layers and then animate on the top peg. And that's Advanced AutoPatch. See you next time.